Some of you may recognize this Tesla tank rendering that I did about a year and a half ago. If you haven't seen it, link above here in the right. I'm going to continue to design and develop this vehicle as an infantry fighting vehicle, sort of in the vein of this Striker that you see right here. And in this video, we're going to start to build a wire model of the Tesla Gator IFV.
My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making. I hope that you like, enjoy, and become a subscriber.
I want to let you know that my sponsor, PCBWay, is having a special right now. $5 for up to 10 boards, maximum 2 layers thick, 24-hour turnaround time. This is for new customers. Check it out in the link below. All right, so to build a wire model like this, you need some sort of a plan. And to make a plan, you need a drawing. So we're going to do a top view and a side view, isometric view, which is a good idea no matter what kind of a model you're building. I'm definitely drawing inspiration from these rock crawlers. If you haven't seen any of those videos, super badass. Lots of that on YouTube. Go check that shit out. This vehicle have a crew of 2 to 3, a driver, some sort of tank commander, possibly a gunner, depending upon how things go, and probably some troop carrying capabilities in the back as well. Don't know exactly how many of those are gonna fit, but we'll see. It has this side entry, which is gonna give the TC some ability to see out, maybe talk to his troops as they walk up alongside of him and they're on patrol, that sort of thing. So a little different layout. And then of course, troop entry in the back. So we're gonna put this drawing together and this is gonna allow us to build the model to the scale that we want and get it built in the correct proportions and the size, all of that stuff. So it's finishing up the top details here. Now, I've also gone ahead and done a rendering, which I will release separately of this vehicle. It's also drawing inspiration from the American Alligator, as you can see here to the right. So look for that video very soon. Let's talk about these plans and how you get them and how you get it to the right size. I know that my vehicle is 5.5 meters length. I figured that out from other vehicles that are in the same category. So that gets us 550 centimeters in length. We translate that out into the top view with the same grid, 1/2 meter grid. That's under 3 meters, meaning you can still push it out of an airplane and airdrop it somewhere, anywhere on the planet. All right, so how did I get this? I need to put this grid on top of here, and to figure out this grid, I need to know the size that I want to build this thing, and I need to figure out a scale to build it at. I've settled on a 1/14th scale, all right? So 1/14th is 0.071 multiplier. If you multiply this 550 over here on the right times 0.071, that gives you 39.05 centimeters, right? And so that's the size grid that I lay on top of my image to get the correct scale. And then I can output it at that size. You see my guy here as well. 180 centimeters tall, roughly my size for the Americans. That's about 5'10". And so you can easily figure out how big your human is next to your vehicle and in the top view as well. All right. So when I go to output this at the printer though, there is a certain amount of bleed. So you'll see here, the lines don't go all the way to the edge of the paper. So you have to take that into account when you go to print. They printed this at 101%, so 1% enlargement to make sure that I can keep the actual size of the vehicle. All right, so for this vehicle, we're gonna build out of 3/32 and 1/16 inch brass tubing and some copper wire. Yeah, I'm stuck in a country that has not fully embraced the metric system. It's interesting, much of the packaging actually has the metric conversion next to the silly fraction. Man, I'm cursed. Anyway, let's just kind of follow along. I'm not going to talk too much in this video here because it's all about sort of watching and putting everything together. I'm going to roll up the brass wheels first, get those things going, hop on the roll bender, get all the circles turned. Enjoy. And that's how I start the wire model build of this Tesla Gator IFV. So the super cool thing about using this technique is you can design and build the vehicle or the object, the inside and the outside at the same time. Very fantastic. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, leave a comment below and let me know why. Look for part two of the wire build coming up very soon. Make sure you give the video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already done so. Hey, and don't forget to follow me on social media. I'm on Facebook sometimes, Twitter usually, and now Instagram. Rock on. Click here to check out some of the other design and making videos that I have that you might enjoy.